Okay. Is that okay? Should I? Okay. No problem.
I'm gonna need to the bathroom.
Okay.
Good morning. Welcome. Glad you're here today in the Lord's house. I know I'm very glad to be here in the Lord's house. I'd like to try to call the worship down. Get you all going. Let's go. Open your hearts to God's love today. In the midst of darkness, we seek the brightness of God's love. Don't be afraid. God is with you. The Lord is your light and your salvation. With the Lord's help, we can overcome the darkness. Even though everything all around us is turbulent, yet God's love is constant. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Our opening hymn will be number 442. It'll be in PowerPoint because I don't believe there's any hymnals out there. The church is one foundation.
Saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that our Lord Jesus Christ came into the world to rescue sinners like you and me. Friends, believe the good news. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen.
Thank you.
Morning.
Make sure I don't have any feedback here this morning. Welcome once again to this house of worship in the midst of conflictive and exciting times that we live in. We're thankful to be gathered together in the house of the Lord today. Thank you for those of you who are with us today. And we are now turning to our scripture readings for this morning. We're going to be looking at a couple of short scripture passages from Psalm 68, verses 32 through 35. Psalm 68, verses 32 through 35 in the Old Testament. And in the New Testament, from Romans chapter 1, verses 14 through 17. Romans chapter 1, verses 14 through 17. Please listen for God's word as we share together, and I'll be reading from the New International Version of the Bible. From Psalm 68, verses 32 through 35. Sing to God, you kingdoms of the earth. Sing praise to the Lord. To him who rides across the highest heavens, the ancient heavens, who thunders with a mighty voice, proclaim the power of God, whose majesty is over Israel, whose power is in the heavens. You, God, are awesome in your sanctuary. The God of Israel gives power and strength to his people. Praise be to God. From Romans chapter 1, verses 14 through 17. I am obligated both to Greeks and non-Greeks, both to the wise and the foolish. That is why I'm so eager to preach the gospel also to you who are in Rome. For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes, first to the Jew, then to the Gentile. For in the gospel, a righteousness of God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from first to last, just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll go ahead and have, I think there's only one child today, and she doesn't really want the sermon at the moment. So we'll go ahead and have our special music.
Thank you.
Today will be a 2-cent meal day, and there'll be a box by the offering. I'll mention it again later. It's right in front of the church. And so we'll be collecting that also today. Thank you.
This is when we collect the 2 cents a meal offering for our food program, for all the services that we offer to the community. And we just invite you, there's a basket in the back, we invite you to keep that gift by your side, and then as we exit the service today, deposit it in the basket. And I'll go ahead and pray and just ask God to bless that offering at this time. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the blessings that you pour out upon us. We thank you that as we gather small coins and small donations together, that they make a huge impact in your kingdom. Lord, we ask that the gifts that we bring at this time would be of a blessing to those who are hungry, those who are in need in our community. That you would continue to direct us in the steps that we would take to be a greater and greater blessing among your people in this place. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Power of God. That's what we're talking about this morning. How are you enjoying the longest summer in human history? It's usually the summer months are flying by, but this year it's different, isn't it? A lot of ups and downs, and if you're watching the news, a lot of things to think about, a lot of things to worry about. Time seems to be passing really, really slowly this year. Things are going slow. It reminds me of a story that I heard of a state trooper who pulled over a car full of nuns because they were driving too slow on the highway. And so he pulled them over, and he went up and talked to the nun who was driving, and he said, "Excuse me, ma'am, I'm sorry to stop you, but you're driving at about 23 miles per hour on the highway, and the speed limit here is 60, and I'm just worried about, you know, your safety. Is everything okay?" And the woman said, "Oh yeah, I'm fine. We're just following the signs. We keep seeing signs that say 23, 23, and so that's what we're doing, is 23 miles an hour." And he said, "Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am. You see, this is Route 23. This is Highway 23, and that's what the numbers are for. You should be looking for the speed limit sign that say MPH at the bottom. That will tell you the speed you should be going, which is about 60 miles an hour." And she said, "Oh, great. Thank you for clearing that up." And so the officer was getting ready to get back in his patrol car, and he noticed the nuns in the back were shaking and sweating, and they looked like they might be sick or something. And so he said, "Sorry, ma'am, to ask again, but your passengers don't look well. Should I leave you all to a hospital or something like that?" And she said, "Oh no, officer, you'll understand. It's just that we just got off Highway 135. So you can imagine they were doing 135 miles an hour on the highway. The passengers were a little nervous. Well, today I'd like to continue with my sermon series on the last part of the Lord's Prayer that says, "For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever." Last week we looked at some aspects of God's kingdom, and this week we will consider the power of God, what it looks like in the Bible, and what it means for us today. As we pray the Lord's Prayer, Jesus invites us to recognize God's power. When it comes to the Bible, finding evidence of God's power is not difficult at all. You can start with creation, where God spoke the entire creation into being using the power of his voice. God's displays of power continue up through the life of Abraham, when God takes a man who was as good as dead and makes him into a warrior and a leader and a father of many nations. We can talk about God's powerful acts as he dealt with the peoples of Israel and Judah, miraculously saving them from enemies, restoring them time and time again, even when they fell from their faith. But today I'd like to focus on God's power in the New Testament. If you notice, Paul says something that might seem a little strange in the text we read from Romans chapter 1. In verse 16, he says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes." So why would Paul speak of being ashamed of something that he describes as the power of God? It might be helpful to start with Paul's words elsewhere when he tells us that God's power is made perfect in weakness. Paul says this in 2 Corinthians verse 12, chapter 12, verse 9, as he's describing a dialogue he had in prayer with God, as he asked God to remove some kind of pesky problem from his life. We don't know what this problem was, if it was a sin that he was dealing with that he couldn't get rid of, if it was a physical problem that he was dealing with. Some people think it might have been his eyesight that seems to have been failing him. And he prayed, he says that he prayed three times for God to take this problem away from him. And three times God responded, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." This statement of Paul kind of summarizes the New Testament experience of God's power. In the Gospels and in the book of Acts, we see God's power at work in all kinds of ways that are not what we would necessarily expect from the powerful God we know from the Old Testament. God does some pretty unexpected things that demonstrate his power in the midst of weakness. He sends his son to earth as the child of a carpenter, a humble village worker, not part of a rich or powerful family. Jesus works amazing miracles through God's power, yet those wondrous acts are not enough to convince Jesus' enemies that he is who he says he is, that he is the Messiah, that he is the Son of God. And finally, Jesus is killed on a cross. Shocking end to a holy life of one who taught about love and forgiveness. And it was the death of Jesus on the cross that would have brought the shame that Paul was speaking of. The cross was the way that the Romans humiliated their enemies and criminals who were not Roman citizens. The cross represented failure, humiliation, and shame to a Roman audience. And yet in the face of the utter powerlessness that the cross represented, God's power raised Jesus from the dead and gave hope to billions of people throughout history. The weakness of Christ's suffering on the cross gave way to the power of resurrection of the Lord of glory. God's power is indeed made perfect in weakness. And this unexpected display of God's power in the midst of weakness continues as we consider the ways God works his plan out down through history. God chooses to work with and through some pretty broken human beings to carry out his purposes. If God wanted to display his power, he couldn't have chosen a more unlikely way to do it. Paul recognized this in his own life, that he was just a cracked clay pot, he says at some point, a person riddled with personal human weaknesses. And yet God chose to use Paul to heal the sick and to make the lame walk again. God chose to use Paul to start dozens of churches around the Roman world. God chose to use Paul to write the majority of the wisdom that is in our New Testament. And God uses even weaker examples of humanity, people like you and me, to accomplish his purposes in the world, so that the glory would be given to God, because it certainly doesn't belong to us. God's strength is made perfect in weakness. Jesus Christ is God's power made flesh. The power of God infused nearly every aspect of Jesus' life and ministry. Jesus' birth took place under miraculous circumstances when God's power was made known when a virgin gave birth to a child. God's power was displayed in the young life of Jesus when, as a 12-year-old boy, he was discovered reasoning with the scholars and the wise people of his land at the temple. At his baptism, a dove descended and a voice was heard from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." God's power was seen as Jesus healed the sick and cast out demons, as he fed people by miraculous means, and as he walked on the water. Jesus was like a walking generator of God's power to do the impossible. Finally, at the time of his crucifixion, he refused to exercise God's power to save himself. Even though, as he said, he could have called down legions of angels to bring him to safety, to fight for him. And yet, if the death of Jesus Christ reflected a lack of God's power, his resurrection was the ultimate display of that power. The power of God over sin and death. And even after his ascension into heaven, the power of God was once again poured out in the form of the promised Holy Spirit, breathing life and comfort and power into every one of the believers. Jesus went on pouring out the power of God even after his death and rising, but now among his church, working in the world. There is so much power in God. The power to heal, the power to forgive, and to free from the bondage of sin. The power to transform hearts and lives. The power to change futures. So much power. And yet, if we're honest, we often feel powerless in our own lives, don't we? Some of us are struggling with illnesses or health conditions that we can't seem to overcome, even with the best medical resources available. Some of us have lost loved ones and we can't understand why God didn't prevent that. Some of us are struggling with addictions or compulsions, and as much as we try, we just can't seem to shake this monkey off our backs. And some of us are just plain overwhelmed by the crisis that our nation and our world is going through right now. COVID-19, demonstrations, economic crises, political crises. We're just tired of it, and we feel powerless. What do we do about it? What do we do? Well, as they say, the first step to overcome a problem is to admit we have a problem. And if you feel powerless, you've recognized that problem, at least in your life. We have to realize that we are often powerless to change or overcome these problems on our own. We need help. We need the presence of others in our lives on our side. We need the power that can only come from God. What is that thing in your life that makes you feel powerless? Don't ignore it. It's not just going to go away. I encourage you that when you go home today after worship, get some paper and a pen or pencil and, and write it down. Write down this thing that is besetting your life. Maybe it's a long list. Maybe it's just one. But write it down. And whenever you pray, bring that with you and set it before the Lord. Put it in God's hands. Because we must remember that the power that we seek is from God and not from us. Let us pray. Gracious God, we confess, even in the face of your power, even as we witness your power in Scripture and we hear of your powerful works in our world today, that we focus on our own powerlessness, that feeling of not being able to escape from things that we feel are crushing in on us, or not being able to shake off the shackles that we would like to get rid of in our lives. Have mercy upon us. Open our eyes to see how we can give these things to you and receive your power. The power to set us free and the power to be with and for others in their moments of need. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As we continue in an attitude of prayer, this is an opportunity for us to bring prayer requests for our community, also Thanksgivings. Mark Reynolds. Okay. We continue to pray for Mark. Is anyone, do we know when he's? Yeah. Do we know when Mark is getting out?
This week, I take him tomorrow for a COVID test, and Thursday he goes after him to get all the removal from his arm.
Okay.
So then he'll be coming back later.
Wonderful. So Mark will be getting out this week. God willing, in the creek don't let us. I saw another hand up. You said also Justin?
Yes.
Justin Fontaine. Are there other requests? Other things?
My dad's brain.
Sorry?
My dad's brain.
Your dad's brain. Pray over David's father.
Isaac Grossman, healing.
Healing for Isaac Grossman. I think we need to put our society in God's hands at this time with all that's going on and the COVID crisis. The doctors and nurses continue to put them in the living.
Our political thing coming up.
Yeah. The political thing. The whole political thing.
Yeah.
Put all of that in God's hands. Yes.
A good outcome for a situation that you're a good friend of mine, you say that I can't put a lot of pressure on.
Okay.
A good outcome.
Amen. Amen. If there are no others, let us come before the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you because you hear our prayers. We thank you that your ear is turned toward us, and you have promised whenever we come before you in prayer, as we pray in faith, that you hear and answer according to your will. Forgive us for the ways that we doubt your power and your presence in this world. Restore faith in us to turn to you, and to trust you to provide for our needs. Lord, we lift up every single one of these people that we've mentioned, our brothers and sisters, our friends. We ask that you would touch each one of their lives. We thank you for the ways that you've been working in their lives and the ways that you have, the miracles that you've already done. We ask that you would continue to work in and touch each and every one of them. Lord, we pray your presence for those who are going through illnesses and sicknesses, those who are in hospital. We think of especially of Mark Reynolds at this time and ask that you would touch and heal him, Lord, of his injuries. We would love to see him restored and among us once again. We pray for all those beset by the coronavirus and the crisis that's going on in our nation right now. We just ask that you would be present, that your healing would be made known in this land, that you would continue to work through the doctors and the nurses and the health professionals. Give them strength, Lord. Give them endurance. Lord, let your spirit be with them in their time of need. We ask that you would be with this nation in all the crises that we are passing through. That you would inspire leadership among our leaders and wisdom and insight to confront every single one of these crises by your strength and by your power. We ask your blessings and your guidance and your grace to be with this community, with this church called Sunset Presbyterian Church, that you would guide and strengthen the leaders, the elders, Lord, those who are serving in all kinds of ways. That you would inspire and encourage and direct our steps. That we would be a greater and greater service to the community in which we find ourselves. Build us up, build up our spirits, Lord. Give us strength, give us your power, that we might reach out in power toward others. We pray all these things in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and we pray also in the words that he taught us to pray in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Do we have any visitors out here today? Okay, we're all family. If you're a family, we're all a family. It's a beautiful thing. And by the way, I'm glad she wasn't on 441. That's for sure. Yeah, it literally, but it's okay. Gotcha. Robbie gets it. Thanks, Robbie. Well, just look around and say hello to everybody. Welcome, everybody. Hello, officer. Back there, there she is. Okay. Go ahead and say hello real quick to everybody.
Good morning, greetings, everybody.
Good morning. Okay, very good. We're going to do some announcements now. And Bible studies for the rest of the summer will be on break until the end of August. For both the English and the Spanish. And of course, the children's Sunday school classes in Spanish and adult Sunday school will both be suspended for now. A weekly food pantry ministry is available to all those in need every Saturday at 8 a.m. following a short worship service. And listen, our food pantry needs canned goods and plastic bags, so if you have some available and you want to make a donation, please bring them here. Appreciate that. Pastor Bryce, are you still offering the church membership classes right now?
Anybody's interested.
Okay, fantastic. If you're thinking about joining and want to know more about being a member of Sunset, contact the church office for more information. The Shower of Love Ministry is present at Sunset every Tuesday and Friday, right, Robbie?
Yes.
That's right, okay. 8 a.m.
Well.
8 a.m. to noon, offering showers and hygiene supplies to those in need. We need to contact you. Please fill out a contact card with your name, address, and email. Session meeting July 20th at 7 p.m. That'll probably be again on Zoom.
Yeah.
Right, okay, we'll be doing that on Zoom. Don't forget to pray for Sunset. This is very important now for everybody and everything, for all our, as we go forward, please keep pursuing prayers and just do it. Don't consider it, just do it. Appreciate that. All right, anyone in need of food or clothing can contact Robbie. Robbie's right over here, or Pastor Bryce.
Can I make a comment?
Sure.
Everybody, please. We've got a massive amount of goodies and bread. So please, everybody take some before you leave. We're going to be outside.
My parents don't need to pray for you.
I'll be outside. Please wear your mask and socially distance yourself. 6 feet. Thank you.
Okay, Robbie, you twisted my arm. I'll get something sweet. That's it. Thank you so much. I wasn't going to, but I will now. All right, we also want to remember the four promotions. This is the Flower with the Flowers every week, and we appreciate them. So they're on 441. Go check them out. And also the Publix, which has just been awesome. That's where all the goodies are coming from, most of them. So thank you for them. Make sure you take care of them. Go over there and shop. Riverland Recovery AA meeting is Monday and Friday noon and Monday night at 7 p.m. at Abiding City Church. It's also known as Grace Alone Church. It's right over here, 1900 Southwest 35th Avenue. So check it out if you need to go there. You know somebody you might. Also, again, I want to remind you with the offering today, if you can dig a little deeper, we have the 2 cents in the room. There's a place right back there where you can put it right alongside your offering. So, Pastor Bryce, if you want to bless the offering.
Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the many blessings that you pour out in our lives. Blessings that we are often even unaware of. For the sun that comes up every morning, for the weather that allows us to come here, for the friends and the family that you bring into our lives, and for the many material gifts that you give us as well. But we bring these tithes and offerings into your presence. We ask that you would bless them, that you would take them and use them according to your plan and your provision in this place. Bless this church to be a light and a presence in this community. We just pray that you would bless each and every person, that we would be a greater and greater blessing to others. We pray all these things in the strong name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Okay, we have our closing hymn, which is 403, but I don't think that matters today because you don't have any hymnals anyway. What a friend we have in Jesus. The lyrics are on the PowerPoint.
Thank you.
go forth into the world, trusting in God's power, even when we feel powerless, putting ourselves in the hands of our Lord. And may the grace, mercy, and peace of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit live and abide with every one of us today and every day. Amen.
Awesome weekend. Wear your mask.